educate. A place where skilled teachers and staff will educate and fill young minds with useful information so that Alexandria's children are the smartest in the nation. Yes. For they rebuilt and improved Jefferson-Houston School as they vowed. So please, join me at this building dedication in giving all those involved with this project a standing ovation.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It is an honor to be here today and to be a part of celebrating the opening of this building. One of the things that we've talked about as a school division is that we are an ACPS family. And this is an opportunity for our family, our community, to come together to celebrate the opening of a brand new building. This building is for our students. And students, I want you to know that you deserve to be educated in this building, this brand new building. So the building is one part of the celebration, this coming together. But within this building, it is important that all of us, as a family, as a community, continue to focus on making sure that we provide every student with the best education that we can provide here in Alexandria. Again, our children deserve nothing less than our best. So as we celebrate this opening, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of you in the room who, in different ways, made this possible. This building epitomizes what we can do as a community, as a wonderful community. This opportunity today is yet another important chapter of a school that is rich in history, with its beginning in the early 70s, as a one-story, all-electric building with an open plan to a brand new state-of-the-art, LEED-certified building, which is designed to provide a strong educational program for students pre-K through 8. This did not happen by accident, but by hard work, the tireless energy, and the driving commitment of all of you here today. You attended community meetings, education specification meetings, you took polls, you participated in surveys. Some of you reviewed Site Plan A and Site Plan B. You voted. You passed out flyers. You made phone calls. You spoke up. You knocked on neighbors' doors. And you helped to build this wonderful building. And during our time of transition, many of you showed up. health pack boxes, and to encourage our kids to have a great end of school year. And when we moved into this building, you were there to unpack boxes and to welcome our students back to school. This is how families take care of each other, and for that, we thank you. So when I transitioned in, there was a lot of discussion about the building and whether the building was going to be ready in time to open school. And there was a lot of buzz in the community. Oh, I think it's going to be open in October, maybe November. But guess what? We opened on time. Sunday, and they were working to clear our hallways and clean rooms. And to our teachers, you guys have been phenomenal in helping pull all of this together. So I want to extend special thanks to our teachers. We really appreciate everything you've done to get ready for school. Coordinating all of the scheduling and communication that needed to go out to our parents. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the admin team, Ms. Rosalind Rice Harris. Who was it? She's in here. Our assistant principal. Here are the words that most kids use. Excellent, great, fabulous, nice, and beautiful. And I think they knocked it out of the park. And this is what this building was about. The other opportunity that I had during my walkthrough, and for those of you who know me, and for those who are getting to know me, you know that I love music, that I'm a musician. And so I was drawn to the band room, where the band, and keep in mind, we are in week two of school, and the band was hard at work. There was excitement, there was learning, and I have to tell you, as a trumpet player, I was a bit intimidated to sit down and try to play the trumpet with these young people. I still have some work to do. So at this time, I'd like for you to join me in welcoming the Jefferson Houston Band under the leadership of Heather Losner. Jefferson Houston Band, I can't wait to hear you another minute. So, Ms. Losner, before you direct this band, I want to thank you for your commitment to growing this music program.
Let's give another round of applause to the band. I know how these kids clarinet and saxophone, then moved all the way up. Advanced up to high school, still clarinet and saxophone, and then because I loved the march and I didn't want to play clarinet and saxophone marching, they put me on in a percussion section, but they wouldn't let me play drums, so they said, we'll give you the cymbals. So I marched with a mighty Titan band playing the cymbals. But it is certainly an honor to be here with you this morning for this wonderful dedication, ribbon cutting of a magnificent, beautiful new elementary school here in the city of Alexandria, but particularly the new Jefferson-Houston Elementary. And so let's give a round of applause to the home of the Jaguars. Yeah! The future Titans for the T.C. Williams, as you advance through your education, you will be our future.
Just a little bit of history. Believe it or not too many years ago, I was a student at the Jefferson 8th Grade Center when it was on this very site. And you may say, gosh, I didn't know there was a grade center here, but there was. It was an old, rustic building that was known as Jefferson Middle School. And I started my education here in Alexandria at Lowes Crouch Elementary. And I always like to tell folks that I've had an opportunity in my 12 years of being educated in public schools in the city to have attended two brand new buildings, school buildings. And when I first started in elementary school at Lowes Crouch in the first grade, those of us who live in what is now an old town or the public housing section that comprise the district for Lowes Crouch, we went to an old rustic building that used to be a factory that my father and his sisters and brothers attended. But fortunately, we only had to go to that building for a couple of years until the new Lowes Crouch opened up. And then I finished my third through seventh grade at Lowes Crouch, brand new building, loved it. Pretty much the same building that's there today, except for it's been renovated and some additions added. And then over here to Jefferson for my eighth grade, and then from Jefferson to George Washington for my freshman year, which George Washington used to be a four-year high school, and then T.C. Williams opened up in 1965. So I was one of the first students in my many to be part of the new T.C. Williams High School. And so I can tell you how honored it is to be a student in a brand new building. But you know, the reality of it all is, and I say this, it's really not about the building at all. It's really about the content. The content of the students, the faculty, the administrators, the parents, the community, everybody that has a hand in helping you grow and learn. And that's really what it's all about. Yes, it's nice to have a wonderful modern building, but you know what? I think as I look around this room, I see a lot of range power in here that can function just as well without having this brand new building. But you have it, take advantage of it, and use it well. And the reason why I say that is simply because this just didn't happen. This was a long journey through a partnership and collaboration with the City Council, past and present members, for many years, along with the Alexandria City Public School Board for many years. And we came together and finally with the community, we finally concluded that this was the best investment that we could make, is to build this brand new building at this site location, replacing the old Jefferson Houston School. Again, the partnership is about commitment, it's about improving the quality of life, not only for the students at the school, but in the community. It was about addressing our future workforce that we love to have in the city as we move forward. And more importantly, it's about the overall attractiveness of the city in terms of not only economic development, but the city's future and its success. Congratulations go out to me. Again, it goes out to the members of the school board and their staff, to the city staff, to the community for your commitment, your involvement, your engagement, your vision, your part of the planning process, to the various, to the members of the construction team, the architects, the engineers, the designers, the general contractor, to the parents, teachers, to the administrators, but most importantly, to you, the students. This is all about you. It's not about us. Again, it's not about the building, but it's about you. And the reason why it's about you is simply because we want you to excel, we want you to be the best, be the best, and we know that you can do just that. I believe in you, we believe in you, and I hope that you believe in you. In closing, I simply say, enjoy this experience, learn as much as you can, and take it with you as you move on to middle school and high school. Have fun, but the bottom line is reach for the stars. Welcome, future Titans. Congratulations.
Strong components of high-performing school is its ability to reach out to the community and to make sure that our parents are fully engaged in the instructional process. It takes a family. And at this time, I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our wonderful PTA and the leadership of Chanel Gaten. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mark Eisenhour, and Mark is not a stranger to this community. He has worked 150% to make sure that we are here today, and Mark has been, I call it the bridge between the facility side and the instruction side, and also the community, to make sure that we are on target and moving forward. So, Mark, I'm going to ask you to come up and share some information with us and take this opportunity to thank you for the work.
Good morning. One man with courage is a majority. That quote from the great Thomas Jefferson, along with many others, will soon adorn the walls of this great school. And our students will learn a lot more about Jefferson and, more importantly, about Charles Hamilton Houston. Believe it or not, many years ago, when we entered this building, the name Jefferson Houston was one of the first things I thought we should change. Why would we change the name of the school named after arguably our greatest president and a giant in the field of education? And Mr. Houston, who was a giant in the field of law and was known as the man who, in a legal sense, killed Jim Crow. That was one of the many battles we fought as we set out on a plan that did not put students in trailers, push for an innovative dining plan that would serve as a model for future projects, found money for a rooftop observatory, and chose a design that respected the neighborhood from the outside, while at the same time looked forward with as many modern amenities and colors as possible. I still want a few more colors. The school, which is not finished and will continue to improve with athletic fields, playgrounds, basketball courts, and a giant compass rose that will greet students as they disembark at the kissing ride, was a direct result of the hard work put in by countless professionals and volunteers who attended hundreds of committee and community meetings. And I would like to, at this time, take the opportunity to thank some of them, and I know I will miss some of them as well. I must start by recognizing the previous school board individuals such as Dr. Sherman, Dr. Holmes, Blanche Kness, Bill Finn, who got this project started. And without them, we would not be here today. I would especially like to thank Helen Morris, those in the front row here, who relentlessly advocated for this project, pushed it forward as a member of the board, and continues to serve as a parent member of the core group, which makes all of the major decisions for this project. I also want to thank the mayor and city council and city manager who provided the funds, and just as importantly, provided support as we worked our way through the approval process. I would also like to thank Dr. Crawley and the school board who were steadfast in their belief that this project and this school will be a success. And they provided invaluable support and guidance as we worked to finish on time and within our budget. Finally, as we welcome our new principal, Dr. Phillips, I must also recognize and thank our students and staff, led by the remarkable Roslyn Rice Harris. We survived more than a year of construction, the threat of state takeover, and many years of sometimes withering criticism by members of our community and the press. The design and construction team responsible for the successful completion has been incredible. Beginning with our ACPS Educational Facilities staff, led by Dr. Graham Holly, and most notably Laurel Handy, who played a huge role in the planning of this school, and Tom O'Kane, who was our construction program manager, who also had to educate me on the basics of construction. One time he sent me an email with a price quote labeled ROM, R-O-M, and I replied to Tom, what is that, range of motion? And he said, well, of course that means one quarter magnitude, so I'm learning. Our project managers, we also have been living with by Jay Brinson, John Montemayor, and Thomas Beck, who have been with this project so long, their job titles have changed. In John's case, John moved on from official note taker of our meetings to now the project manager. This would not have been done without the help of Gresham Burley. The MBO Koi Architects, led by Bob Bajay, Justin Walton, Doug Dickerson, Steve Davis, Tom Smith, and Stephen Bingler, who have the vision to include a rooftop solar observatory. Who else, what other school is going to have one of those? We have, by far, one of the most beautiful schools in the country. Turner Construction. I'm not sure what else I can say about this group. They have been nothing short of incredible as they work with us to complete the design and find ways against impossible odds to keep us on time and within our budget. Even in winter, that never seemed to end. I did not stop from finishing the school in time for our students. I have to recognize a few individuals, including our project superintendent, Steve Davis, who arrived on site every day for the last year and a half at 4:30, despite a one-hour commute. Joe Swanson, Aaron Briano, Sean Holliday, Joe Gold, John Sikowski, and Hank the Liverpool. I mention Hank for a particular reason. One of Hank's jobs every single morning drive around the neighborhood and make sure we're kind of parking next to W, and which is one other way to work with our neighbors to make this process as painless as possible. At one point, there were more than 150 people on site, working harder than anybody I've ever seen. Some of the subcontractors amazed me with their work ethic and professionalism. You realize that one man is primarily responsible for almost all of the rubber bands we find in the school. You realize how many thousands of linear square feet that is. I could go on all day and name individuals such as Bruce from Euille and Kevin from Kimmy Horn who played critical roles in the success of the project. On the city side, Al Cox, Stephen Sample, Mike Kurz, Kirk Kurlach, John Lambert, and many others were critical in getting everything approved and sanctioned by the VAR. Also, I have committed got to meet this project with gentleman named Eric Fessler, who informed me that we had uncovered a slaughterhouse in our field, which is interesting, and he showed us how to preserve it, how to document it, and how to turn it into a learning tool for our students, so I appreciate that. Additionally, Ron Pagawa and David Jesus from RPCA will play an increasingly important role as the fields, playgrounds, and restoration of the Durant Center takes place over the next few months. And speaking of approvals, what would we have done without Duncan Blair? Building a huge project in Alexandria, much less in a historic district, is just a little bit challenging. Duncan guided us through every aspect of making sure we met every requirement the city put before us. So at some point, now I must stop. I must stop praising the individuals who completed these tasks because it was their job to do so and return to the community. And I'm just going to name a few parents: Beth Coase, Chanel Gaten, Cassandra Lewis, Jimmy Struthers. Jimmy and I competed for carrying the most boxes over the last few weeks. Dana Andrews and many, many others who attended meetings and volunteered their time because their children attended. Finally, I do want to recognize a few community members. Dino, I'm going to recognize you. Dino Drudy, who attended more than 150 community meetings. Dino does not have, Dino, stand up, please. Thank you. Neighbors on West Street had a lot of constructive criticism for us, and we appreciate it, and we have a better project because of it. Last night, I spoke at the West Belleville Association meeting. I was not invited, but stayed. And I honestly came and thanked them. I thanked them for their input, and folks like Dino and folks like Colonel Gentry, who also lives on West Street and has come countless times to tutor our kids on Saturday. None of these folks have kids. But these folks want the best for their students, best for the students in this community, and they're a part of what made this project successful. And speaking of students, I would now like to turn it over to a couple of our own. You've already heard them perform once, and now they're going to say a few words. We're going to have to hear from Treyanti Rogers and Eliza Cook.
Some of the most respected historical figures possess this precious ability, to climb over or move obstacles, and we need to make sure the past doesn't affect the children's sense of pride and hope in this building, so they do great things with confidence. What a gift that is from the community to the children. My hope and prayer, my blessing to these walls, is that this building will provide shelter for children to develop their intellect, confidence, stamina, to overcome the obstacles we all know life presents. Education levels the playing field in the real world. Adults and children advance their thinking when they are confident in the content they study and practice, and safe in the space they do it in. So here's another quote, Jaguars. Once you learn to read, you will forever be free. Does anybody know who this historical figure is? Well, when I was in second grade, the Scholastic Reading List came home with a wonderful list of books on the back to purchase. I wanted them all. My parents made a modest salary. My dad was a teacher by day and a janitor by night. My mom stayed at home, and they told me I could only pick one book. So I looked down that list. Clifford, Scooby-Doo, all kinds of colorful options, but I landed on this book, and I still carry it with me everywhere I've moved. It is called Frederick Douglass Fights for Freedom, and he is the one who said these quotes. I loved him right away when I heard this story. One day, he said to his friend Gus, "I can write better than you can." "No, you can't," Gus said. "I go to school, and you're only just learning." But Frederick said it again. "I can write better than you can." "No, you can't." Gus was getting mad. "Yes, I can." "Can't." "Can." Finally, Gus lost his temper. "Prove it," he shouted. Frederick picked up a piece of chalk. He drew all the letters he knew of the alphabet on the fence. Gus began to laugh. "Look," he cried, "you made half of them upside down." Frederick wanted to smile, but he kept a straight face. "All right," he said. "Show me how to make them right side up." And Gus did, and so one way or another, Frederick learned. He learned until he could read and write as well as any of his friends. So, clever determination, brilliant. A child's will turned into a man's greatness. Frederick Douglass was key in freeing and emancipating slavery. And he did that through the pursuit of his own education. He said all these quotes that I've read to you today, and here's one more. "I would unite with anybody to do right and with nobody to do wrong. Two superintendents, two city managers, two councils, two school boards were part of delivering this building to the community. We knew it was right to replace that building and start new, a bright setting for learning and creating dynamic experiences for the children of the ACPS, the teachers, and the community. This building is a symbol, and it is important. It is a symbol of a community who climbs over obstacles to get things done and who thinks of the students' needs first. We all know there are a lot of debates and details, but this is the result. And it means something. Children, their needs come first. Thank you to all of you who worked hours on this project, from the elected bodies to the staff and the construction workers. Now that I've spent 20 months as a school board member, I cannot even imagine what you guys had to do to make this a plan into the bricks and mortar that set this building in place. This modest plaque commemorates the effort of that work, and I'm proud to present it to Principal Phillips.
Dr. Crawley, Mayor Euille, City Council members, members of the school board, honored guests, I thank you for your attendance today. It means a lot to show the support of the students and the staff at Jefferson-Houston. More importantly, I'd like to thank the staff, the administrative team, the students, the parents, and the community for your support during the construction of Jefferson-Houston. It is a beautiful building, and I know you went through a lot to get here. I do look forward to your continued support throughout the years, because the students really do deserve it. It is a beautiful building, but more importantly, the children are why we are here. This is what we do. We teach, we educate, but the building just makes it a little bit nicer to do it in. So thank you for your attendance today again. Students, you have been a wonderful audience as well. Thank you for your time today as well. Teachers, It has been a pleasure having you down here today. Thank you.
So at this point, we are going to, as a family, go through the dedication, which is listed in your program. We set apart this building for the service of our students, teachers, parents, and community. We offer our heartfelt thanks to our community whose benefits has made it possible for us to have this building. Future leaders of our nation.
We dedicate this building